issues in planning your next project, and how you're going to be talking about using social media to build your brand and online community. So today's leaders must embrace social media for 3 reasons. The first one being building your brand, the second one is engaging your audience, and the third one is learning from others. Many people have social media but aren't using it the right way. So I'm going to walk you through the 3 realms of social media and how to use them strategically. The first one, what's building your brand? You need to develop a brand mantra, which is basically a quick, simple, effective, memorable statement that allows people to know who you are and what you have to offer. So now you ask, how to create a brand mantra? Well, first you need to determine your emotional appeal. What do people think about you? What personality traits do you have, such as are you friendly, are you dedicated, are you motivated? Secondly, you need to determine your description, identifying who you are and what your brand is for. As a student, yours may be the major that you're in or skills that you possess, such as are you a finance major, an accounting major, are you a healthcare management major? Some skills you may possess are you good at analyzing documents? Are you creative? Lastly, you need to determine your function, what you do or what you will do, something that relates to your career, such as graphic designing or analyzing or auditing, whatever pertains to your career. Lastly, you need to put it all together and create a simple 3-word statement that people will know you by, such as motivating others to do their best. That's something a coach would probably have as their brand mantra. Here at the table, I think 3 of the most common companies that we would know, Nike, Disney, and McDonald's. So Nike, for their emotional appeal, they have authentic. Disney has fun, and McDonald's also has fun. In order to describe Nike, they have athletic. Disney has family-oriented. McDonald's also has family-oriented. The function for Nike is obviously performance, and Disney is entertainment, and McDonald's is food. The next step is engaging effectively with your audience. There's so many people around you, and it's really important to engage with your peers, your professors, your friends, and especially the public. Social media is the best way to get your voice out there and for people to know who you are and what you aspire to be. You also want to learn from others. The best way to learn is from others. And the best thing about social media is that you get instant feedback. People will tell you what they like about what you posted or what they didn't like, and this will help you improve your strategy and techniques. Now I'm going to hand it over to Christian.
The article talks about 5 social media must-dos. And the first one sounds kind of obvious, but it's to Google yourself. And this way you kind of know what employers see whenever they Google your name. And if somebody with the same name has been like stuck up 7-Eleven, you might want to know that and ask them for that. The second one is protect your identity. And the way they say to do this is actually buy the domain name of your name and then use that to open up the social media outlets. And then this way you can have it all under one umbrella and know where it all is and know it's all you. The third one is create a business profile. This one's pretty simple, just like with a LinkedIn, where just stay relevant inside of the workforce community. The fourth one is use what you have at work. This is one of your corporate platforms that they build for internal use for their employees. And this way you can just collaborate with your coworkers. And the last one is post public content. This way you can stay up to date and stay relevant. And then the second piece of it is finding the right presence. They actually divided this up into 2 different categories. It was a personal and professional. And first, we'll talk about personal. And the first one is personal and private. This is more like your family, friends. And the message you want to send with this is you want to keep in contact with them, keep a relationship with them. And the social media tool for this is Facebook. And then the goals with this, with your brand, you want to show your commitment towards that person, towards your your family. And then the engaging is you want to strengthen your ties. You want to strengthen all the relationships you have with them. And the learning is you want to keep abreast the changes in your social network. So you want to know what's different about your friends, what they're doing, what's new. And the second one is your personal and your public. This is more a societal base. The message with this is that you're passionate about your ideas and you want to be able to share them with your community. Example social media tools for this is your blogs, your Twitter, and your YouTube. Now your brand is going to become known for your ideas. So this way people associate your ideas with you and help kind of build your personal image within your social community. To engage, this helps you find new outlets. And then to learn. social media tools on this is like Gamma or other corporate platforms. This is more kind of internal, more closed circuit. And then the brand with this one is you want to enhance your image at work. So if you want to keep moving up, or you want to just a better image within your workforce community, within your corporation, this helps with that. As Engage, this is a collaborating, boosting productivity and effectiveness. This cuts wasted costs. This helps you be more efficient in your workforce. And the last one is Learn. This is a delivery of colleagues input, so get your kind of following at work to help them and you rise together. It's like a cohesive unit. And the last one is Professional and Public. This is more for your professional peers, so more like the people like your competitors, especially nowadays with people moving back and forth between different corporations. This helps with that. The sample social media tools with this one is LinkedIn, Twitter, and sector-specific communities. Oh, I'm sorry, I skipped the message. Message is you're confident and growing professional. But these kind of both tie in with each other because this means that you're not complacent and you're going to continue to grow in the industry that you're in already. And then the brand with this is you want to build peer recognition so people know you before you even step foot in that building. If you want to go for another job interview for somebody similar to the field you're already in, or if you want to help build contracts or just help with that. And then to learn with this, it helps boost industry knowledge and develop yourself. This is more that tacit knowledge that you get, not something you find in books, just something you find from experience with yourself or through others. And with this, I'll pass it off to Hyman.
Okay, and now we're
going to
watch a brief video. Ellen mentioned our tools with the agreed example.
Will it blend? That is the question. Love my new iPad. It does a ton of cool things, but will it blend? That is the question. Doesn't quite fit in the jar, but I can take care of that. I knew I could get the iPad in the BlendTec Total Blender. I think I'll press the iBlend question.
Okay, so as marketing director actually suggested that they do a YouTube, video like this, and Mr. Dickinson actually never had no idea what YouTube was. He was able to reach a large audience by building a dedicated Will It Blend website. So he uses the brand. He made his own YouTube channel. He made merchandise. He also did his own website. He achieved tremendous success through social media and his development of software school. Brand shows the tremendous value of social media and the effects that it has on his business. So even though he didn't know what YouTube was after utilizing this, he got 9 million views and sales in BlendTec went up 7 times in the first 3 years, which is pretty impressive because he only spends a couple hundred dollars to buy the iPad and then pretty much it. That's all his advertising costs. So executives can use social media to engage with employers, and customers, and investors. Today's leaders must embrace social media for, in 3 primary reasons. First, they must provide a low-cost platform in which they can communicate who they are to people in their company as well as people outside their company. Second, they must allow to engage rapidly with peers, employees, and especially the younger generation. So Mr. Dickinson here, he's a grandfather. He never used YouTube ever, and he utilized YouTube to communicate to a younger crowd and market his product in a more fun way, I guess. The third reason would be to give the opportunity to learn instant information and gratuitous feedback. He's more than welcome to log onto YouTube and read the comments or receive feedback about the product and the video and see what he can do to improve from there. Now we're going to be talking about the risks of social media. First, it's going to be managing social capital. So I'm sure everybody here has received a Facebook request, friend request from somebody they might not be well acquainted with. You might just know their workplace and they don't really know how to go about that. How do you go about respectfully declining a friend request because you don't know that person very well? There's a boundary between a personal and professional line, and that line can be blurry, but the article mentions that you should build your audience slowly and be selective about who is in your audience. The second risk of social media would be managing your intellectual capital. So 75% of recruiters and HR professionals say your research candidates online before you know the hiring process. And the corporate legal departments also use the database to like look up employees because they fear the company's name might be tarnished. So you might like sign a waiver whenever you start a new job saying you're not going to use that company's name on a social media platform. So the article mentions that you should be consistent and authentic in what you post and not involve your personal life in your work life. The third risk of social media would be managing your progress. So everybody has a strategy on how they keep their social media together. Whether it be your Facebook, your LinkedIn, you should have a strategy on how you go about maintaining momentum. So you should keep track of how many useful connections you have, you make per month, and go on how to maintain success on social media. Okay. And with that, we're going to go into the quiz. The first question would be, the three realms of social media are blank, engage, and learn. Second question, which social platform is best built to build a social professional network? The third would be, what's one of the major growing concerns about social media today? And the fourth question would be, one way to protect your blank is to purchase an internet